The ending really got me. Hi everyone, welcome to IGIS React and Review. My name is Ashmita and I hope you all are doing well. And today's detailed analysis is of a Malayalam film that recently got an OTT release on Zee5. The movie that I'm talking about is Operation Java. Written and co-directed by Tarun Murthy, this film is probably one of the most realistically depicted cybercrime thrillers that I've watched. So yes, let's not delay this any further and deep dive into the detailed analysis. The storyline gives us a glimpse in the lives of its two main leads, that is Anthony George and Vinay Dasan. Both are BTech graduates, bright, honest, determined. But the only issue is that they are unemployed. Despite having an engineering degree, we see them struggle in life and manage their finances by doing small odd jobs. This very setup itself smacks you with the harsh reality of the country's unemployed youth who are struggling to find jobs despite of having an education. Anthony and Vinay are determined to prove their worth as they self-investigate a piracy case of the blockbuster film Premam. I later found out that this was a true incident that happened back in 2015 that somebody had leaked this film on Torrent. So we see both these protagonists approach the Kerala Cybercrime Department to share their findings. And later, with the help of the police officers, they try to solve the case and nab the culprit. That sets the pace of the film and we see eventually how Anthony and Vinay are helping the Cybercrime Department to solve different cases. Interestingly, the storyline of this film is linear as well as non-linear at the same time. It is like a collection of different case files that the cybercrime tries to solve, and parallelly we get to see Anthony and Vinay's journey to prove their worth from time to time. What I really loved about the storyline is that how engaging it was to see all these different cases and how realistically and beautifully the cybercrime was trying to solve and get to the culprit. Once again, the writing completely won me over and there are so many things to rave about it, starting with the jump from one story to another. As mentioned before, the movie deals with solving different types of cybercrimes. And the transition from one case to the another was done pretty well and it did not break the flow of the narration for me. Second, the extremely realistic depiction of the department. There are no fancy cars, no fancy gadgets, no fancy office setup, no fancy tech, just because it is a cybercrime thriller. The way the character have been written, the way they talk, the way they behave, the way they solve the cases, it is so realistic and natural. It gives the entire movie a very, very authentic feel. Third, the emotional quotient that has been added, which has elevated the entire writing of this film. While there is obviously a certain sense of thrill when you see the cases being cracked, you can't help but empathize with the two leads, Anthony and Vinay. Be it their overall situation, their struggle, their constant strive to prove themselves, everything that I was watching, I felt emotionally invested and there was a sense of connect with these two characters. Fourth, the ending message. I loved and hated the ending, both at the same time. Love because of how hard-hitting the message was about the unemployed youth or the temporary workers in our country. And hated because I really, really wanted Anthony and Vinay to have some stability by the end of the film. But fact is always a bitter pill than fiction, and I was really, really heartbroken to see how Anthony and Vinay's arc ended in the film. You know, there's a scene at the end where Vinay is telling to the senior police officer that we are fine with the situation, we love working here, we don't even want salary, but just let us work here. I honestly wanted to reach out to him and comfort him. That is how emotionally invested I was in these two main characters. One can really feel that Tarun Murthy has actually written these two characters with a lot of empathy in mind. The best part about the direction was the overall treatment of this film. I mean, a movie solely dedicated to the cybercrime department and the temporary workers of our country. I mean, we don't get to see that often. If I look into the individual case files, I really enjoyed the first case where they are trying to solve the piracy issue and the final case where they are trying to catch the murderer. The final case specifically had me completely engrossed into the film. I also like the range of the cybercrimes that has been shown in this film, and every case has been treated very differently and uniquely. It almost seems like you are watching an anthology, but it is from the same director. The best technical aspect of this film is the editing. And I say this because given the format of the film, where there are so many events involved that are not connected to each other, the edit definitely would have been challenging. In fact, while watching the film, I imagined myself at the position of the editor and thinking, My God, what a challenge it would have been. Number one, showing all these cases in a streamlined manner so that the film does not look disconnected when there is a transition. Second, it being a thriller, the editor had to ensure that the pacing of this film is maintained so that the audience does not get bored and also are constantly thinking what is going to happen next. So yes, nothing but a huge, huge round of applause for the editor, Nishad Yusuf. Thrilling is how I would put the cinematography in a single word, because there are a lot of chase sequences throughout the run of this film, but none of them look similar. The distinction that has been made in the cinematography from one case to another, it's actually quite impressive. My favorite piece of cinematographic work was the final murder case and how it was shot. It is a complete nighttime sequence, and I don't know, it is probably a bias inside me. If I see any nighttime sequences shot well, I get thoroughly impressed. One of the biggest reasons why this movie gives you an adrenaline rush is because of the beautiful background score that has been given by James Bejoy. The movie also has songs which is situational based, and they are quite nice, but unfortunately Z5 has been so lazy with their subtitle work that the songs did not have any subtitles, and I could also find couple of spelling mistakes there. I don't know, maybe it is just my gut feeling, but I think a lot of dialogues have not been subtitled properly. Now coming to the performances, the movie wouldn't have looked so real and authentic if not for the fabulous performances by the entire cast. Now the movie has a very huge cast, but what I want to focus on are the two main leads, Balu Varghese and Lukman Lukko. It is their performance that has shined throughout this film. The emotional investment on characters that I was talking about, it's because of how they have acted. Their performance has given a face to the thousands and thousands of faceless temporary workers that are part of our economy. Their performance gave me a sense of emotional connect, and it forced me to think that my goodness, there are so many people who have an education but who cannot prove their worth in our country. Talking about all the supporting cast, specifically the people who played the cybercrime police officers, they were so good. Their demeanor, their body language, the way they were talking, it really felt like they were part of the police department. I mean, the list is very long, but the performances by, say, Irshad, Vinayakan, Shine Chapo, Prashant, everybody was just fantastic. This was not only just a thriller and an enjoyable watch for me, there were so many aspects that stayed with me after the movie got over. Number one was, of course, the hard-hitting reality of the temporary workers and the educated unemployed youth of our country. Second was the harsh reality that has been shown of the range of cybercrimes that happen in our country. I mean, data privacy at this point is just a myth. In addition to being a thriller, the audience should actually view this film for self-educating that how we need to protect ourselves from all of these cybercrimes that are so prevalent in our country. Lastly, I got thoroughly convinced that you do not need a very big budget to make a thrilling, engaging film. It is your storytelling, it is your writing, it is your performances. All of these things matter more. So kudos to all the makers of this film. And yes, those were my thoughts on the 2021 Malayalam film Operation Java. It is streaming on Z5. And yes, that was it from me today. I hope you've come till the end of the video and have enjoyed watching this review. I will see you on my next video, guys. Bye-bye.